Man, the 90s sure were lit, weren't they? We had legit action heroes. We had awesome movies. The Dallas Cowboys were unstoppable. Nolan Ryan was still pitching no-hitters. Bodybuilders did not look like circus freaks who were passing away in their mid-20s. And high school football was badass. I think people in general were healthier, and I'm not making any claims in this video. This is for entertainment purposes only, and I just would like your opinion. So feel free to chime in the comments section. But something interesting happened in 1996. And that's when it seems that things began to change dramatically in society, which has progressed into something that I don't think that we can really make a whole lot of sense of. But let me show you this. What was introduced in 1996? None other than the genetically modified soybean. A genetically modified soybean is a soybean that has had DNA introduced using genetic engineering techniques in 1996. It was first released after it was introduced by Monsanto. And in 2014, that's a whole lot of land. 82% of all of the soybeans produced are now genetically modified. Now, these soybeans are Roundup ready, which means you can spray as much glyphosate on them as possible. And what it does is it interferes with the synthesis of essential amino acids that the plant needs to grow. And when they can't get those amino acids, the plant dies. Not the case with Roundup ready soybeans. There is a lot of discussion about endocrine and reproductive effects from glyphosate exposure. And I just want to know from you, do you think that there's a connection between what we are seeing in society currently and the fact that 82% of all soybeans are now Roundup ready GMO soybeans? So we're basically, in most cases, if you like to eat conventional chocolate and cereal and breakfast bars and ice cream and different breads and pasta sauce and salad dressing and, you know, soy sauce, all this stuff. I mean, there's hundreds of products that have soy lecithin or some form of soy in the product, and there's a high probability that the soy is genetically modified. To make matters more interesting, if you're still with me here at 3 minutes, researchers in Japan use soybean compound to make catfish 100% female. So they have modified the endocrine system of the catfish using a compound extracted from soybeans to change the gender of the fish. So I'm not making any claims here. I'm just wondering if you guys think there might be a connection.